y'all so much for coming out today. We really appreciate it. It's so great, you know, to be able to be back in person and making live music with people again. It's actually kind of surreal to see people out in the audience, as we all haven't been able to. The next piece we're going to play is Sheltering Sky by the composer John Mackey. This piece basically paints with every color except really bright. It's all the pastels, all the Easter colors. And it's his harmonic language is super unique and using it in all these colors without actually going to the full bore. So the next piece will be John Mackey's Sheltering Sky.
Thank you.
will be playing is entitled City Trees by Michael Markowsi. In the program notes, you'll notice that he tells a pretty elaborate story about how this piece really reflects his move from Arizona to New York City and how he was struggling during the move, really finding himself in a new place, not knowing people, and how he would take walks to clear his mind. And what he would notice is that over time, there were these trees and weeds that would sprout up in between the cracks in the pavement and the asphalt, and they would somehow find a way in this less than conducive atmosphere for growth, for plants, that they find a way to bloom and really grow into these awesome living plants. And it's about really embracing positive change and new ideas in life. So the next piece we'll be playing is City Trees by Michael Markowsi.
Thank you.
remiss without thanking a few people. First off, thank you so much to Dr. Dan Belongia. He's been such an instrumental figure in the program, and is, for me in particular, has been so helpful in making a transition to a new state, a new part of the world. Moving across country and not knowing anybody. He has been so helpful and has provided just absolutely wonderful guidance. Dr. Jeff Bright and Dr. Jeff Cass have been incredibly supportive of the program. We can't thank the department and the College of Fine Arts and Humanities enough. The last piece that we'll be playing today is entitled Melodious Thunk, which bears a strange uniqueness to the jazz pianist, Thelonious Monk, and really plays on his kind of performance style, the way he was real clunky, and the word thunk really means it's an onomatopoeia. It sounds like it's spelled thunk, and you should be hearing all sorts of those kind of sounds throughout this. So without further ado, our last piece is Melodious Thunk by David Biedenbender.
Thank you.
offered to give his life.
Thank you. Thank you. That's very great. Good afternoon, everyone. I just want to take a brief moment to mention a few important things before we play the final selection this afternoon. In no order of importance, they're all very, very important. The first thing to say is how nice it is to see and how nice it is to perform. Again, with an audience, we've all missed it so very, very much. My heart's kind of pounding through my chest here right now. That's kind of a thrilling piece there, too, to stand and dance in front of with these incredible players and incredible people. They're your people. Thank you for what you've done here with them. It's my treat to get to dance and sing and make music with them for a living. It's been far too long since we got to do this. Since we've seen you last, we released a CD that we hope you all have. If you like it, please let us know. You can find it on all the streaming services now, and you know, we even have an old-fashioned plastic rectangle. Or is that a square? Maybe it's a square. That we're, of course, very, very proud of. And we've rescheduled, as I'm sure all, if not most of us, know here, we've rescheduled our Carnegie concert, and we're now back on track and on the runway toward December 15th. Of course, something we're all terribly, terribly excited about, even though it was sabotaged in what I refer to as the rapture, Friday the 13th of March, 2020. I will never forget the date for its poetry and its terrible circumstances. But we're back, and so nice to see. Thank you for joining us. Two other things to mention here. As I said, no order of importance. I cannot miss an opportunity to embarrass the man, to torment the man, my dear friend, one of my heroes. Everybody, Professor Cooper is back here, and he celebrated a birthday yesterday. So would everybody say happy birthday, Professor Cooper? Thank you for being here, Mr. Cooper. Our last piece today is the David Maslanka work called Hosannas. I wrote some notes in the program, but it is a funny activity that we participate in. We hand you this thing and then we turn the lights off. So it's hard for folks to get a chance to read these and get your phone out and put your lights on, and maybe you're concerned someone's going to get frustrated with you. So for that reason, and the fact that maybe I can be brief here if I read these words, I can be brief and accurate. When I wing it, I find that I'm neither one of those. So I wrote here is the monumental Hosannas by David Maslanka. A Hosanna is a shout of praise. Movements 1 through 6 is a 7-movement work. Many of the movements are connected to each other. The slides will help you keep track of where we are. They're a diverse and sweeping exploration of the potential sounds of the wind ensemble. Then movement 7 is a bit singular. It's in itself very special and unique. The Richard Beale poem, A Litany for Courage and the Seasons, is emblematic and symbolic of one's life journey. There are a few extraordinary details about today's performance. This piece was commissioned and premiered by my teacher at the University of Miami on the occasion of his retirement concert. And I understand Professor Green is watching on the live stream. Hello, sir. I love you. We look forward to seeing you in December. It's an honor to play your piece. I'm conducting from the score you gave, so thank you for that. This piece will always be meaningful to me in that regard. And its final movement being emblematic of someone's life journey. Dr. Harris and Dr. Clements and I realized there was an opportunity for us to mourn and honor the passing of our colleague Brian Knasser and his wife Ann Shields. Brian and Ann were both major contributors to music at Arkansas Tech and in our community. For many, many years, Brian most consistently through accompaniment of the choral program, though he contributed everywhere. So Dr. Harris and Dr. Clements seemed perfectly suited folks to help us mourn, help us honor, help us recognize the untimely passing of Brian and Ann earlier this year. I wrote Sung Lovingly today by Dr. John Clements and Dr. Christopher Harris. We mourn and honor the passing of our colleagues. colleagues and friends, Brian Knatzer and Ann Shields. Brian and Ann tragically passed away on August 15th. Their contributions to Arkansas Tech University, countless individual students and music throughout our region and the state of Arkansas, were profound, and they are deeply missed. Rest in peace, Brian and Ann. Later in the program, we have the words to the poem. The last stanza says, "May God come and stay in my heart through the round of seasons. May God make me love each season more, though none are new. And if I should die before the birds come back from the south, may my spirit be waiting for them in the trees." Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. This is the David Maslanka Hosannas.
Thank you. Thank you.